if ever I collapse and they're waiting for the medics, don't pound on my chest, please. I want to go. You know how many people are saying, don't go, Mom, don't go, Dad, don't go, don't go. I want to go, okay? Just FYI. I always think of this gospel, I'm thinking, he's just about there, and all of a sudden, boom, we're back. Seriously, who clings on to such a life? But the Lord was moved with pity, not for the young man, but for his mother. How important it says she was a widow. Who else was a widow but Mary, the mother of Jesus? And this sort of sets things up to look at her life in many ways, because with her son, her only son, dead now, this woman is sort of consigned to being a beggar, to live off the land, to live off the goodness of people. But she is to be a beggar with a little tin can. And Jesus was so sad, and he might have been pondering, what will happen to my own mother? He has been saying in Mark's gospel over and over again to the disciples, the Son of Man must die, and then he will rise, but he will die nonetheless. And as a very good and caring son, what will happen to my mother? You know, who will take care of her? And I'm sure in the back of his mind that was always, you know, and of course, how prudent. Let's pick the youngest. The youngest will probably outlive her. Let's make sure the youngest, the strongest, the healthiest. Let's make sure the youngest is the one to care for my mother. In Paul's letter, how beautiful about the body. How beautiful about the church. You know, we think so much as how important and special the Holy Father is. And Benedict is an incredible gift to us. I don't know, I just can't. I thought when John Paul died, I thought, well, that's it now, you know, in at least our lifetime, we're not going to be able to get any superstars like this. This is just incredible. And we get Pope Benedict, I'm thinking, wow, seriously, in his own right, who could have followed such a charismatic pope but Pope Benedict? In a very humble, loving way. And he's a German, of course, you know. He's a real sharp cookie. But anyways, but we think of him as so important. You are very important in God's church. Very important. You may not be necessarily the head of the church. You may not necessarily be the heart of the church. You may not be the two lungs of the church. You may not be the kidneys. Who knows? Maybe we're a toenail, right? Maybe we're a toe. You know, I'm beginning to realize as I get older, toes are very important. I have a priest friend who's losing his toes because he has a severe case of diabetes, and those toes are very important. You are very important in God's church. Never discount that. Again, you know, we look at certain people, and yes, there are those who are very gifted in theology, far more than myself, and in Scripture. Of course, we have to have the gift of discernment, be able to determine, are they teaching us God's way, or are they teaching us their way? But there are some who are so gifted. What's incredibly sad is when they don't use those gifts. When I don't use those gifts, when you don't use your gifts, and you are a part of the body, in a sinful state, in immorality, in mortal sin, we are like to the body an infection, a terrible infection. And we can take care of that. But see, sometimes we don't want to change ourselves. For some reason, we think we can just sort of stick to the body, but we don't realize that that toe, that blemish is getting worse and worse, and it's becoming dead. But what's happening is it's starting to affect other parts of the body and the skin. It, in our sinful state, we can hurt the body of Christ. How many times does some people say, you know, it doesn't hurt anybody but me, I can do whatever I want? That is not true. They really need to be corrected on that. Because whether they do what they want or not, they are a part of the body of Christ, and that affects me. and that affects you. Oftentimes when we don't perform or do our ministry enthusiastically, or we just don't bother, we let someone else do it, that just puts a heavier burden on other people. And it's like, we have two legs, we have toes. Hopefully you have 10 of them, you know. Eight function well too, by the way. But nonetheless, you know, we have a body God gives us to use to serve him and to serve the body of Christ. For us to say, I'm not that important, or I'm unnecessary, that really speaks poorly of God, who has called you and called me to serve him. As a priest, it doesn't matter what parish I'm in, there's not the richest, the poorest, the best, and the not so good. No. You know, God has called me to the priesthood. That's why when my buddy the other day said, oh, my work is so mundane compared to yours, it's not as exciting. Huh. You're a priest of God. How can that not possibly be important? And you, the baptized people of God, you too, you cannot discount the importance of your place in the church. You may not be the heart, you may not be the lungs, you may not be the head. God calls us to specific ministries. God has called some to be single, some has called some to be married, some have called a few of us to be religious. And that's a calling from God. I don't just look up to God and say, I have a right to be married, I have a right to be single, I have a right to be a priest or religious. That's God's calling. And you'll find, as you listen to God, you'll find a great deal of happiness, a great deal of peace, not peace as the world calls it, but the peace of Christ. And as you minister in a state of grace, going to frequent confession, you must have a very bad pastor. You know how many confessions I heard Saturday? So, your pastor's going to make a few changes. Instead of having less time, we're going to have more time. That's my fault, not yours. Now, we have good priests over at the Shrine and a Holy Redeemer. And at St. Faustina, that's true. But I have to offer more time. That's my challenge, not yours. But when we have a lot of time, I'm going to herd you all into line, because you are the body of Christ. And if I can go to confession once a week, you can go once a month, yes? Let us stand and pray.